I know the Senate Appropriations Committee spent a lot of time on markups this week, Senator.
Yes, when the Senate takes up the budget and goes into markups, where we take a look at the governor's recommendation, and now the House has given us their recommendation for the next fiscal year, which begins July 1st, 2019, there are quite a few items in there that we have to look through. Some of those items are employees and what we call FTEs, or full-time employees. Based on research, we found over 1,000 unfilled positions that have been unfilled for over 6 months. Some of these positions had even been unfilled since 2007. Now, however, even though these positions were unfilled, your state taxpayer dollars were still going to that department in order to pay for this position, even though that position was not being utilized. What our departments are doing now is a classic bait and switch. They're informing the legislature that they are going to hire these employees. They accept the money for hiring these employees. Then they don't hire those unfilled positions and use that money elsewhere. Where they are using that money may be a legitimate purpose. It may be they couldn't find an employee, and so they contracted that service out. However, we as the legislature should know where that money is being spent in the form of transparency. I believe in transparency when it comes to your state taxpayer dollars. So furthermore, we are being hoodwinked by many of the departments. When the departments tell us that they are going to budget for 1,000 full-time employees, however, they only hire 850 full-time employees and use the other money that we've allocated for those additional 150 employees for other places in their department. This has got to stop.
When they do this, is this a situation where that's, for lack of a better word, the money allotted to them is open-ended? Even though they say they're going to hire 1,000 and don't, they can still use that money for other purposes?
Well, many times we have what we call flexibility, flex language, and we allow the department some degree of flexibility within their department, whether that's 1%, 5%, 10%, or 25%. So what we need to do as a legislature is go back and look at the amount of flexibility that we allow within these departments to move money from personal service to other expense line items. We will be discussing that flexibility language next week in the Senate Appropriations Committee, and I will be looking to decrease the amount of flexibility they have within departments. Missouri businesses don't run this way. When Missouri businesses go through a budgeting process and budget certain employees, they don't give that to the departments and then tell the departments, well, if you only hire 150 out of the 200 employees that we budgeted, then you can use the money from those 50 employees to go and use on different expenses. That needs to be approved, and it needs to be more transparent in state government.
I know you've been following the revenues and how much Missouri's bringing in, and the numbers remain down, I think, since last year?
Yes. Monday, this coming Monday, April 15th, is the tax deadline when everyone has to file their tax returns. So current year-to-date through April 10th of this year versus prior year, we are $271 million less in revenues than we had in the prior year. Now, our budgets that we're looking through for the next year included $625 million of a carryover from this year to the next year. Obviously, if we are $271 million less so far this year compared to last year, that could definitely affect our budget and our budget projections for the next fiscal year. So this is something that I know myself as well as my colleagues are keeping a close eye on, and we want to see come Monday what those revenues finally come in at.
And that, like you say, has an effect on the upcoming budget year, which we're working on now, and that fiscal year starts in July.
That's right. You know, if we end up with a budget shortfall for this current fiscal year, which ends June 30th, 2019, we will not be able to use any carryover to the next fiscal year, and that will affect the budget line items that we're working on right now in the Senate. In Missouri, we have to have a balanced budget. We can't print off money like the federal government does, and I want to make sure that we have a fiscally conservative budget.